social media tend to spread like wildfire, and prank videos are some of the most popular ones.
Now, one of the latest trends involves parents pranking their kids, and has people asking, is this just innocent fun or cruel and potentially harmful?
Let me tell you something. I'm from a family that pranks children.
Harshly. My favorite Francis family story of all time. Mm-hmm. Picture it. It's her birthday.
Yeah.
How old were you?
I think I'm 5 or 6. I think I'm five.
What happened?
Yeah, what happened was my father calls me and he says, happy birthday. And he gives me a bag and inside of it is a basket and a bell for a bike. And I was like, oh my goodness, you got me a bike. My father goes, no, we didn't get you a bike. Well, he says, come here. And he attached the basket to my belt and put the bell in my hand. And he said, now, when you go outside, I want you to get up some steam and start running. And when you go past somebody, you say, bring, bring, coming through. And my family watched me do that for hours.
I just can see you going, bring, bring.
And I was so sad. Bring, bring, coming through.
Black
bring,
people bring. Sat there and watched her for hours. And you know they called everyone.
They did.
You got to come see Frances. We got her running up and down the block.
And they had a bike. There was a bike.
Well, she got later that night.
Yes, I got later.
Once it was dark.
Once it was dark.
And the joke got tired.
Yes.
Well, are some pranks worse than others? I think yes.
Yes. The invisible prank involves an orchestrated plan to make one person believe that they are invisible, usually a young child.
This seems so psycho to me. Family members tell the kid they're going to make them disappear.
Mm-hmm. And then they cover them with a blanket and say some magic words. And then it's pulled off and everyone pretends they can't see the child. Where
now,
do they go?
Now, some kids play along at first, but after a while they become, I think, universally terrified.
Yes.
So we have a video. Be prepared. Take a look.
No, girl. I'm smiling.
Got it.
You got it. Let me see. Oh my God.
Thought about it, so we went to our Facebook page to ask, do you think videos of parents pranking children are funny or too far?
Yeah.
36% said funny, 64% said too far.
Girl, yeah.
Woo! You gotta let go of the joke quick.
Yeah, you do.
I mean, even the Jimmy Kimmel thing with the taking the Halloween candy every year, some of those kids I feel so bad for.
They are upset. Well, joining us on the phone to give his professional opinion is child psychologist Dr. Ernest Katz. Welcome to Me Time, Dr. Katz.
Thank you so much. Thank you. This is a really important topic.
So what effect does something like this, or could something, a prank like this, have on a kid?
It could be really profound. I mean, we're talking about parents that are doing things that border on abusive. And you got to wonder, like, who are they trying to make laugh?
Yeah.
They are laughing. These are adults laughing at the expense of children. I became a child psychologist because kids don't have their own voice.
Yes.
And we have to help them be able to project that voice into society. And here we are regressively going backwards and using children as the butt of jokes. And it can be profound.
I heard
the story. Yeah, one of you was pranked yourself. What an experience of pretending like you're a bicycle for an afternoon or whatever.
It's so wrong.
You are resilient folks. I mean, you are comedians. You know how to kind of like take pain and turn that into humor and then project it out into the world. Mm-hmm. But the typical child does not know how to do that.
Yeah. Yes.
So, you know, when we take a sensitive child and then you put them through something like this, it can have profound impact.
Yes, or make them become comedians.
Yeah.
It could happen.
It's one of those things, too, where I say to myself, it's like, it feels like what you were saying, like, who's being made, who's laughing?
Yeah.
Like, we have to, as comedians, we've said to friends of ours, children are not bits.
Right.
They're not comedic bit opportunities. They're actual human beings.
And it feels like also now, Dr. Katz, with social media, parents, you know, it's one thing if you were doing it and it's a joke inside your house. spouse, right? It's another thing when you're putting it out in the world, and it's now being seen by millions of people, and there's a gratification, it feels like, for on the side of the prankster, the parent.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And look at what we are modeling to our children. Mm-hmm. Here we are, on the one hand, we're trying to tell them, hey, use these tools responsibly. Social media is good. It can be your friend. But you have to be careful, and here's how to be careful. And then we do things like this and show them that you can have disregard for people's emotions. What about bullying? Mm-hmm. You know, if children do this to themselves, somebody's going to end up in the principal's office.
That's absolutely true.
And I think some of these parents need to be sent to the principal's office, too.
Yes.
Is there a way to, how would you describe where the line is to somebody who's just not getting it? Who's like, look, we're just having fun.
Yeah, I really do appreciate that idea of, like, if it's a private family gathering and people are doing, you know, little jokes and things, and they're not taking it to the point where a child gets hysterical.
Right.
Because that is over the line. That child is demonstrating that they cannot manage this. It's too much. And so parents don't know how to judge that. Some do, of course, and will back off.
Yeah.
But you don't want to get to that point and then try to bring a child back after you've terrorized them.
Yes.
Because that will last, and it can last a lifetime.
Yeah, you're saying this is terrorizing and not teasing.
Exactly. And so where exactly is the boundary? It depends on the child.
Right.
You know, it's hard to kind of like give a general description of what that is.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Katz.
Thank you for joining us. We appreciate your
expertise.
You guys
are terrific. Keep it going. Just keep doing what you do.
Oh, thank you very much.
Me Time with Frangela.